So guys, today we're remixing it up a little bit and actually doing an overview, hopefully never having to really talk about the experience and a review of this knife. But this is of course the Spyderco Matriarch 2, and this one of course has the Emerson Wave feature on it. Before we get into this review or overview, please do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. So let's get into this. Primarily just to inform you guys that one, this knife exists, and just kind of bring it up as a defensive option, because I've always been looking for, especially in this day and age, where things like handguns, you know, even in a place that's as gun friendly as Alaska, the handgun is still really not a very good friend, and it's not something that you can take just anywhere. And so today we're going to be discussing alternative options, or at least one alternative option, to having a handgun that can be equally as effective in a defensive situation. And so that's primarily why I wanted to do this video, is to bring up this knife and one, put it on your radar in case you guys are in fact looking for alternative defensive options that are not a handgun or a firearm, but you still also need a high level of defense, something more than just a simple little defensive pen, or something even more than something like this Benchmade 942, which is a pretty good defensive knife, but it's certainly in comparison, these two edges, I mean, there's no comparison here. This thing would do a lot more damage than this. So that's primarily the premise to this video, and if it sounds interesting, then stick around. Okay guys, so with that whole intro out of the way, and with some nice tabletop decorations, like I said, today we are going to be taking a look at Spyderco Matriarch 2. And of course this one, unlike just the normal Matriarch 2, this one has the Emerson Wave feature on it. So basically, for those who are unfamiliar with the Wave, what this means is, if you can imagine this sitting in your pocket like this, if you needed to pull this out very fast, you would just twist the knife. So you basically grab it up here, or you know, somewhere on the handle, and you twist it in your pocket. And so if you're carrying this on your right side pocket, this would pick up your pocket pant material, and as you're deploying, it would, hopefully I can kind of get this on camera, basically do this as you deploy. And if you do that with speed, it'll kind of create momentum and flick the knife out legitimately as you're pulling it out of your pocket. The blade will deploy. So arguably very hyped up the Wave is, but it's basically the fastest way to deploy a knife, because you deploy it by pulling it out of your pants. So arguable, but they are very nice and very reliable features, especially on this one. The Wave is very preeminent, and I've already kind of played around with it to see how easy it is to deploy, and it is very easy to deploy with the Wave. So aside from that, basically, if you guys don't really know the whole Matriarch and Civilian, the Matriarch is the smaller sister to the Civilian, basically, the Spyderco Civilian. And the Spyderco Civilian is very similar to this, but it has G10 handles, and it's a 4.1 inch blade. This is a 3.5 inch, and it has the FRN handles. And basically the Civilian, just like the Matriarch, the Civilian was originally made to be for undercover officers who could not have handguns or guns, but they still needed a very, very strong protection, or something that could really do a lot of damage in a defensive situation should have they ever needed it. So that's basically the premise to the Civilian, and the Matriarch was simply made as a response to knife laws. In some cities and states, you can't have a 4.1 inch blade, and so sometimes you can only have up to a 3.5 inch blade. So that's why the Matriarch was made, was to basically, for real life civilians, have something that it was more realistically carryable for the masses. And so, like I said, the standard Matriarch does not have this Wave feature, but unlike the Civilian, and I think what's a little bit better than the Civilian, is you can actually get Matriarchs that have the Wave, like this one here. So basically what makes this knife so aggressive, if you can't already tell, is it has a full spider edge, and it's in an S shape. And this tip, by the way, I apologize for shakiness, it is really cold out here. But this shape here is very, very, very aggressive, and this knife is not meant for cutting open boxes. This is not meant to be an EDC knife like this. This is basically your standard of measure for EDC knives, a Benchmade 940. And so this is basically what your EDC knife looks like. This is not an EDC knife at all. It actually has a very thin and extremely fragile tip. In fact, most people who own these knives that try and put them into an EDC, including the civilian people who own civilians or matriarchs that try and end up putting them into a EDC roll, end up snapping at least a little bit of the tip off. And that is because if you ever actually handle a matriarch, you'll notice you'll notice that the tip is in extraordinarily thin, and since it is ground only on one side, it is very fragile. But that is not a real concern, because once again, this knife is not really designed with the intentions of opening a box. This knife is designed to have the intentions basically of a handgun. You know, this handgun, you don't go around thinking you can open boxes with a Glock 19. That's not the intentions of a Glock 19. This thing is defensive, and that is its intention, that is its service, that is its duty. So just like this knife, you kind of have to, whenever you go for a matriarch or a civilian or anything that has a full spider edge like this, you basically have to realize that you're getting a defensive option. You're not getting a knife like this that's designed to be more like a tool. You're getting, well, in a way, it's a tool, but you're getting it as a defensive tool. And this is, once again, basically like a handgun. You're not going around expecting that you can do everything in the world with a handgun. This is only meant for one thing, and that is defensive situations. So once again, like this knife, it's only meant for one thing, defensive situations. And so you're never really going to use this to like open boxes. You could in a pinch, of course. It does have a very sharp VG10 edge, but that's not its real objective. Anyways, getting on to the more defensive, or at least when I think about it defensively, I have to say that I actually like this knife quite a bit. And as far as the materials go, it is definitely a little bit of a downgrade from the civilian. The civilian uses G10, but I actually like this FRN, not so much because I think FRN's a superior handle option. It definitely isn't better than G10, but I like the texturing they put on the FRN Spyderco as a whole, because this this particular pattern is extremely grippy. It's very, very nice to lock into. And the G10 on the civilian is a lot like, I don't have it on me right now, but it's basically exactly like the Spyderco Paramilitary 2. And the Paramilitary 2 isn't horrible for traction. It certainly has traction, but this is definitely a level above. So I really like the FRN handle scales, because they offer a lot of bidirectional traction, couldn't think of that word in the moment. And so it's really comfortable. About the only thing that really surprised me about this knife, and that I don't like as far as ergonomics go, is the fact that there's no jimping up here on this top. I think it's a little bit awkward that there's no jimping up top, because this knife's one and only design is to be defensive, and it's in those kinds of defensive situations that you really need to lock in on that knife and get a really firm hold of your knife to do either a slashing cut or, you know, do some kind of defensive maneuver with your knife. And so I think it's a little bit awkward that there aren't any jimpings up here, but it is definitely not unusable, because of course the spider kind of leaf styled blade is still very prevalent here, and so it definitely curves upward. So while there is no jimping, you can get a pretty good, it's slippery, but you can get a pretty good hold there if you just press straight forward instead of kind of trying to ramp up. So there is enough traction, but I would like jimping up there. I would say that would be one recommendation if they were to make like a Matriarch 3. But aside from that, I definitely like the overall size of it. I think it's a little bit better than a civilian. I can definitely see where the civilian was needed in a police line of work, but I think for everyday carry, for carrying something that is potentially going to be your replacement to a handgun, or that you have to carry in situations like, I know a lot of jobs, even up here in Alaska, do not allow you to carry, even concealed, which is crazy in my opinion, but anyways, they don't allow you to carry concealed, so pretty much every single day when you go to work, you'd be putting on this. And so I think for an everyday carry knife for a civilian, I think the Matriarch's a lot better because it's a smaller package, but yet it still has enough potency that if you do have to pull it out, it certainly would do the trick. And so I like the size being just a little bit smaller. It also helps reduce the overall weight. And this knife is pretty stout. It does have full stainless steel liners. Of course, they're not showing here, but they are embedded in the knife. So it's a very rigid knife. You guys can see there's no frame flex here, or there's just a tiny bit of frame flex, but not much. And that's because, like I said, one, it's a lockback, and two, it has skeletonized stainless steel liners. So it is very stiff, and once again, very rigid. And I think that goes back to improving ergonomics, or making the knife feel a lot more comfortable and ready in hand. So as far as it goes, other things, this is a four-directional clip here. You can move it up, down, left, right. Personally, I would not, especially since I already got the wave feature, this is not a knife I would move to this side, because one, tip down sucks, and secondly, if you did move this tip down, you would not be able to use the wave feature, so it'd be kind of pointless to put this knife like that. But it does, it has the option. And of course, it is ambidextrous. Something I like about the Matriarch a lot is that it, like a lot of Spyderco knives, is completely ambidextrous. This knife obviously has the wave, which is ambi, the hole here is ambi, and then of course for your locking mechanism, it's a lockback, which is also ambidextrous. So this knife, if you are a left or a right-handed person, is completely ambidextrous. It makes no difference whether you are right or you are left. So aside from that, I also really like, I have to say, I don't have many lockbacks, and this is my first lockback from Spyderco. And so I have to say that this thing is actually really, really smooth, especially for it only being like an $85 knife. It's very, very smooth for a lockback. That's really nice. And you guys can see, you can easily Spidey flick this thing out if you want to do that. There are many different ways of opening it, but I have to say, I really like the overall locking mechanism. Of course, being that it's a lockback, it's very solid, and there is no up, down, left, right play. It's a very solid knife. So next, going over into budget for the materials and everything, this is a Seki City Japan knife, so that is a plus in my opinion. I like Seki City Japan. I think they make fantastic knives, definitely equal in the quality of a US made knife like this Benchmade. So no complaints there. This knife does use VG10 for $85, which on the onset seems a little expensive, especially nowadays, but in fairness, I think that is largely that cost is so expensive because of this wild blade shape. Because obviously, putting this on a grinder and grinding a very flat, straight edge is very easy to do on a machine. But this, grinding a fully serrated blade at this S angle, is significantly harder. And in addition to this, this is not a knife that you're really going to be using that much. Once again, it's a lot like a gun. I would hope you're not using this in an everyday carry situation that frequently. So, well, I'm not saying that you can just have poor quality steel and will just pay whatever you want for it. I'm not overly concerned about this being VG10, just for the fact that the probability of really realistically using this knife is pretty much slim to none. So why go overboard and have something like CPM S30V on a knife that you're probably never going to realistically use in the application that it was designed for? So for me, I'm willing to take that, and it also helps lower the cost of this knife. This knife is about half the price of the Civilian by Spyderco. So that is really appreciated. This thing on Amazon, when I got it, was around $85. So that's really reasonable, especially, like I said, for being such a good defensive knife. It's definitely well worth that cost, in my opinion. That's basically all I have to say with features and what I personally think about it and kind of why I ended up getting it. Once again, I really do like this knife as a defensive option, it and the Civilian, because there are many, especially nowadays with guns being so hotly contested. I wish they weren't so hotly contested, but with handguns, especially handguns, being so vilified in, you know, media, social media, you know, YouTube, TV, everything. Guns are not a very popular subject. And like I said, when you go out to work, there's many places that do not allow you to have such a gun on you, even if it's concealed carry, which I realize you may just be able to conceal anyways. And that's kind of what I would do. But getting that point aside, if you do actually want to be employed at that employer for a long point or long term, you may not want to carry. And so it kind of puts you in this weird area where you want to be able to protect yourself effectively should the need ever arise. And while I will be the first to say this knife, even being as aggressive as it is definitely no match for a Glock 19 like this, but it certainly helps level the playing fields. And once again, I would much rather have this in a defensive situation than something like this. And once again, this is not a bad knife for tactical situations, but this is certainly way better. And like I said, this helps bridge that gap of being able to legally, or maybe even just in your job with the code of conduct, be able to have an ample protection for yourself. Another good place for this is in colleges, because a lot of colleges, my college I go to included, do not allow you to have a handgun in many of the buildings, but they allow you to have a knife in those same buildings. And while I'm sure if you showed them this blade, they would probably freak out, but they, so long as it's closed like this and it looks like a knife, looks like another knife, you know, they would not really care if you were carrying this knife. So in those types of situations, in a college type of situation, once again, this is certainly no match to a gun specifically, but it is definitely better. It's a lot better than nothing, and it's even better than, you know, a tactical knife like this. So those are some really great places to use this knife, and that's kind of my mindset to having a knife like this. It allows you to go to places where you wouldn't normally be able to go with something like a firearm and still be amply protected should the need arise. As far as it goes with the whole wave feature, I do personally recommend it, because while waves are a little overhyped in my opinion, especially by Emerson, they definitely are fast to draw, quick to deploy, and really easy to use, so long as you train with them. Just like any kind of specialized system, you have to train with it to make sure that you will deploy it correctly under pressure. But it is not that hard. It's pretty easy when it's sitting in your pants like this to pretty much just grab it like this, rotate it like this, more like you gotta catch the pants, but you kind of like rotate it like this and then pull it out. It's not the most comfortable position to be in, but it is doable to just basically hold it like this and then pull it out and deploy. So it's doable and certainly effective. Guys, that is basically my overview on the Spyderco Matriarch 2 and why I got one, why I like them, why I want to carry one, and just overall why I think they're good knives. Hopefully this has kind of helped you guys, because I know for me, like I said, I always try and think of how I can have a solid defense regardless to where I go, and I think the Matriarch helps with that. And once again, defensive pens and other things, they have their place too, but if you don't have to quite go that far down, then having a nice, really defensive knife like the Matriarch 2 is a very nice bonus. So anyways, guys, that's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.